हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर 12 एरियाज रिलेटेड टू सर्कल्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो व्हाट वी हैव कवर्ड, आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट व्हाट आर द बेसिक्स ऑफ सर्कल। ओके, आई हैव टोल्ड यू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द सर्कल, आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट सर्कमफेरेंस, रेडियस, डायमीटर, ओके, एंड व्हाट इज द एरिया ऑफ द सर्कल, एंड ऑल्सो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड दैट what will be the areas of some parts of the circle like semicircles and quadrants. Okay, what will be the area of concentric circle, that I have told you, and also we have discussed about some useful result, that if two circles touches internally, two circles touches externally, okay, and what is the formula of if a wheel is rotating, okay, then what will be the formula that how many revolutions that wheel will take in 1 minute. Okay, so the formula related to that also we have discussed in the last part of the video. Okay, in the discussion of that I have also told you the exercise 12.1, which is very easy, okay, that is given in NCERT, and we have discussed I think 2 questions of R.D. Sharma. So today what we are going to do, today we will see the exercise 12.2 of this chapter. Okay, so exercise 12.2, today we will discuss it. So students, the very first question of exercise 12.2 is what? The question one is, the radii of two circles are 19 centimeter and 9 cm respectively. Okay, the radii of two circles are 19 cm and 9 cm. So suppose R1 is the radius of first circle, that is 19 cm, and R2 is the radius of second circle, that is 9 cm. It is given. Okay, find the radius of the circle which has circumference equal to the sum of the circumferences of these two circles. Basically what we have to do, we have to find the radius of that circle, okay, whose circumference is equal to the sum of circumferences of these two. Means, suppose the circumference of this circle is C1. So the formula will be 2πr1. The circumference of this circle is C2. So the formula will be 2πr2. Okay. And the circumference of this circle is 2πr. Okay. Where r, the radius we have to find. Okay. This radius r we have to find. So according to question, what is given? It is given that circumference of this circle is equal to the sum of circumferences of these circle. Okay, so basically it is given that C is equal to C1 plus C2. So we have to solve it and to find the R. So C is what? C is 2πr. C1 is what? It is 2πr1. And C2 is what? It is 2πr2. Okay. Just take 2π common from these two. So what will be left? Here it is R1 and here it is R2. And here it is 2πr. So 2π and 2π will be cancelled out. So what is left? R is left from here. So R is equal to R1 plus R2. Okay. Now only we have to put the values of R1 and R2. R1 is 19 cm and R2 is 9 cm. When we add these two, so we will get what? 28 cm, and this will be the value of the radius of that circle that is required. Okay, so this is the required radius that is asked in this question. So students, you can pause the video and note it down, the solution of this question. Coming to the second question is also like the first question. Second question is, the radius of two circles are 8 cm and 6 cm. Okay, this is the second question, and again it is given that radius of two circles, the first one is 8 cm and the second one is 6 cm. Okay. Find the radius of the circle having area equal to the sum of areas of these two circles. Basically, we have to find again the radius of that circle whose area is equal to the area of these two circles. Okay. So, students, we know very well, suppose the area of this circle is A1. Okay. So, its area will be what? Pi R1 square. Is it clear? Okay. Area of the circle is what? Area of the circle is pi R square. The formula for area of the circle is pi R square. Okay. So, if it is A1, then it will be pi R1 square. Area of the second circle, pi R2 square. And area of this circle, suppose it is A, it will be pi R square. Okay. In the question, the condition is given, according to the question, the condition is given that the sum of the area of this circle is equal to the sum of the areas of these two. Means A is equal to A1 plus A2. This condition is given. Now, just put all the values. A is what? A is pi R square. Here R we have to find. And A1 is pi R1 square. A2 is pi R2 square. Okay. So again what we can do? We can take common pi. So only R1 square plus R2 square will be left. Okay. And here it is pi R square. So again pi and pi will be cancelled out. What is left? Only R square is equal to R1 square plus R2 square. Okay. Now, just put the values. Okay. Just put the value. So, R1 is 8. So, it will be 8 square. R2 is 6. So, it will be 6 square. Here it is R square. 8 is square is 64. 6 square is 36. 64, 36, it is 100. So, R square is equal to 100. So, R will be what? 10 centimeter. Okay. Here, we have to take square root. And when you will take a square root, if R square is 100, then R will be what? R will be 10 centimeter. Okay, students? So, this is the solution of second question. Just pause the video and note it down. Now students, coming to the next question, and next question is question number 3. Okay, question number 3 is what? Given figure depicts an archery target marked with its 5 scoring areas from the center outwards as gold, red, blue, black and white. Okay, so students, as you can see the figure, okay, this is the figure of an archery. Okay, it depicts an archery and here the scoring areas, the highest scoring area will be what? In the middle, that is gold, and then it is red area, okay, then it is blue area, this area, and then it is black area, and then white area. Okay, so the figure is like this. So basically it is given that the diameter of the region representing gold score is 21 centimeter. Okay. So, its diameter is given, the gold, okay. So, the diameter of, this is question number 3, and diameter of gold region, it is given what? 21 centimeter. It is given 21 centimeter, okay. And each of the other bands is 10.5 centimeter wide, okay. Means the width of each band is given 10.5 centimeter, means it is 10.5, okay, this is 10.5, this is also 10.5, the width of each band is given 10.5, okay. Find the area of each of the 5 scoring regions. So basically we have, what we have to find here, we have to find that what will be the area of the gold region, what will be the area of the red region, what will be the area of blue region, black region and white region. Okay. So students, here I am telling you the concept. Okay. And whatever the calculations will be there, that you will do by yourself. Okay. I am giving you just the concept. How you will solve. See, finding the area of the gold region, it is very easy because it is a complete circle. Okay, and if the diameter of gold region is given, so you can find the radius of gold region. And suppose it is R1. Okay, suppose it is R1. So R1 will be what? 10.5 centimeter. Okay, R1 will be 10.5. Firstly, what I am going to do? Firstly, I am going to find all the radii, means radius of gold region, then radius of this, from this center to this red, the band of red region, and then means suppose it is R1. So firstly, we'll find R1. This is R1. Suppose it is R2, the radius of second circle. Then suppose it is R3, the radius of third circle. Suppose it is R4, okay, and then it is R5. So firstly, let us find what will be the value of R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. Then we will talk about their area. Okay, so R1 is 10.5. What will be R2, students? What will be the value of R2? See, if we add the width of the band in R1, what we will get? We will get R2. Are you getting this? If the first circle is like this, whose radius is 10.5, okay, and if we add the width, and width is also 10.5, width is also what? 10.5. Okay, then we reach to the second circle. Then we reach to the what? Then we reach to the second circle. Okay, so R2 will also be what? R2 will also be, it is 10.5, means what we have to do? We have to add the width of the band, the width of the band in the radius. Okay, so R2 will be what? R1 is also 10.5 and width of the band is also 10.5, so it will be 21 centimeter. Okay, so R2 will be 21 centimeter. R3 will be what? Now what we have to do? We have to add R2 plus width of the band, and width of the band is 10.5. As you can see in the figure, that if in R2 we will add the width of the band, okay, then what we will get? We will get the radius of the third circle, and that is what? That is R3. So R3 will be, R2 is 21 plus 10.5, means what we will get? 31.5 centimeter. Okay, R4 will be what? Now, as you know very well, that in the previous radius we have to add the width of the band. Okay, so R3 is 31.5 and then we have to add 10.5, so it will be 42 centimeter. And the last radius, R5, so again we have to do the same thing. In R4 we have to add the width of the band, and that will be R4 plus 10.5. R4 is 42 centimeter. We have to add 10.5, then it will be 52.5 centimeter. So these are the five radius of the five circles. But one thing we have to understand here, that when we want to find, suppose it is here I have written, when we want to find the area, okay? So finding the area of the gold region, it is very easy. What we have to do? Area of gold region. How we will find? We have to calculate what? Pi R1 square. Okay? As you can see the figure, we have to find the area of the gold region. For that, R1 radius is there. So for that, R1 radius is there. Okay, so we have to calculate AG, and that is 22/7. R1 is what? R1 is 10.5. We can write it 21/2 also. So 21/2. 7 threes are 21. Okay. And 2 times it is 11. So 11 threes are 33 into 21 upon 2. Okay. So it will be 33 ones are 33, and 30, 3 2s are 66 and 3 69. So 693 upon 2, that will be 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, and 2 6s are 12, and 2 5s are 10. Okay, so 346.5 centimeter square. It is the area of the first region, that is gold. Okay, so the area of the gold region is 346.5. Now, students, how we will find the area of red region? Think about it. How we will find the area of the red region? So, students, as you can see here, that here you have to apply the concept of concentric circle. I have told you that if you want to find the area of this region, this is a ring, okay, or also you can say that this is a concentric circle, okay. So if two radius is there, here it is R and here it is R, suppose it is R1 and it is R2. So what you have to do, you have to find pi R2 square minus pi R1 square, then only you will get the area of the shaded region. Okay, so here you have to find the area of the red region, and for that you have to do what? You have to find pi. Okay, for the second circle, the radius is 2 R2 square minus pi R1 square. Okay, just take pi as common. So if you will take pi as common, what will be there? R2 square minus R1 square. Okay, here also you can write 22 by 7. R2 square, you can write it as R2 plus R1 and R2 minus R1. Because it is A square minus B square, then you can apply this. Okay, now 22 by 7. R2 is what? R2 is 21. And R1 is what? R1 is 10.5. Okay, here also 21 minus 10.5. So as you can see here that it is 22 by 7. 21 plus 10, it is 31.5. Okay, and here it is 10.5. Now students, you will solve this decimal. Okay, this 31.5, you can write it, you can write it as 63 by 2, and this can be written as 21 by 2. 10.5, it is the half of 21, so we can write it as 21 by 2. 31.5, it is the half of 63 by 2, so 63, so we can write it as 63 upon 2. So 7 9 is a 63, okay. 2, it will cancel it in 11 times. So 11 9s are 99 into 21. Okay. And then it is upon 2. So what it will be? Okay. It will be 91 9s are 91 and 99 2s are 198. Okay. And if you will add 198 plus 9, so it will be 207. To 2079 upon 2 divided by 2, so it will be 2 1s are 2, 0, 2 3s are 6, and 2 9s are 18, 2 5s are 10. So 1039 centimeter square. Okay, 1039 centimeter square. This will be the area of the red region. Okay, this will be what? This will be the area of the red region. Okay, students. So I think you have understood. See what I have done. One more time I am going to explain you that what I have done. Firstly, students, here the firstly we have supposed that the radius of the smallest circle is R1. Okay, radius of the second circle is R2. Radius of the second circle, third circle is R3. Fourth circle is R4. Fifth circle is R5. Okay. We have found all the values of the radius. Okay, R1 is given, and according to that, and also what is given, the width of the band, that is 10.5. okay, so if we want to know the value of the second radius, we have to add the width of the band in R1. Okay, then only we'll get what? The value of the R2. If we want to find the value of the R3, what we have to do? We have to add the width of the band in R2. Okay, if we want to find the value of the R4, we have to add the width of the band in R3. Like this, we have found all the radii. Okay, then now we have to find the areas of all the we have to find the areas of the scoring area. Okay, so firstly we have found the area of the gold region. That is very easy, only we have to apply the formula pi r1 square, because the radius of that particular region is what? R1. Okay, now to find the area of the second region AR, we have to apply the concept of what? Concentric circle. And if we want to find the shaded region, the area of the shaded region, what we have to do? We have to find the difference of the areas of these two circles. Okay, first and second. So if we subtract the area of the gold region from the area of the this region, second circle, okay, then we will get what? The area of the red region. Okay, and like this we have found pi r2 square minus pi r1 square. Now one thing you have to think, students, that if we have to find the area of blue region, then what we will do? Area of blue region, then what we will do? Then what we will do, we'll find the value of pi r3 square minus pi r2 square. Okay, are you getting this? If we subtract this circle, okay, the area of this circle from the area of the third circle, then we will get what? The area of the blue circle, blue region. Okay, so as we have applied here, this in the same manner we will apply it for blue region. Okay, you will solve this equation and find the value of what will be the area of blue region. In the same manner, we will find the area of black region. What it will be? It will be pi r4 to square minus pi r3 square. Okay, in the same manner, I have written this equation as I have written this. Okay, and you have to also solve it and find what will be the value and what will be the area of white region. It will be pi r5 square minus pi r4 square. Okay, in the same manner you have to find this also. So students, the area of two scoring areas I have told you, area of gold region and area of red region, and rest three you have to find yourself. Okay, you have to find it by yourself. Just try to understand the figure and the concept of the question, then easily you can solve this question. Okay, so just pause the video and note it down. Coming to the question number 4, students, question number 4 is what? The wheels of a car are of diameter 80 cm each. Okay, so it is given that there is a car whose wheels are of the diameter 80 cm. Okay, diameter is 80 cm. How many complete revolutions does each wheel make in 10 minutes when the car is traveling at the speed of 66 km per hour? Okay, so basically time is given 10 minutes. Okay, we have to find the number of complete revolution in 10 minutes. Okay, so as you know that we suppose that the number of revolution as n. So here it is asked n, and speed is given 66 km per hour. Okay, so this much information is given and we have to find the value of complete revolution, and it is given that use pi is equal to 22/7. Okay, so if the diameter is 80 cm, then what will be the radius of the wheel? It will be 40 cm. Okay, then what will be the circumference of wheel? Okay, circumference of wheel. Why we are finding circumference as I have told you the formula, okay, the number of revolution, okay, the number of complete revolution by a wheel in 1 minute, okay. So we'll use that formula. Firstly, let us find what will be the circumference of the circle. So it is 2 pi r, okay. So 2 pi into r, that is 40. So suppose it is 80 pi. It is the circumference of the circle, okay. And one more thing, here it is given that speed in 66 km per hour. And here you can see that time you are having in minute. Okay, so we have to do what? Firstly, in our practical life, the wheel, okay, the diameter of the wheel is given in centimeter. So we have to find this distance also in centimeter. So we have to change this 66 km per hour. So we have to change it in centimeters. Okay. So this 66 km per hour, we have to change it in centimeter per minute. Okay, centimeter per minute. And for that, what we have to do, see, in 1 kilometer, there is 1000 meter. And in 1 meter, there is 100 centimeter. So it will be in 1 kilometer, there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this much centimeter. Okay, in 1 kilometer, 1000 meter, in 1 meter, 100 centimeter. So yeah, we have to multiply it. So 1 kilometer will be this much centimeter. And you know very well that in 1 hour, there is 60 minutes. So we have to multiply it by this upon 60. So it will be converted into the centimeter per minute. Okay, and 100 will be cancelled out. This will cancel it in 11, so it will be 1140. Okay, 110,000 centimeter per minute. Now it is changed in centimeter per minute. Okay, so the formula that we have discussed in the last part of the video, that number of complete revolution in 10 minutes. Okay, so basically we have to find in 10 minutes. So it will be distance traveled in 10 minutes upon circumference of the wheel. So students, this will be the formula for 10 minutes. Okay, in one, for 1 minute we have studied that number of complete revolution for 1 minute, distance traveled in 1 minute, and the circumference of the wheel. Okay, so let us know, it is n, number of revolution we have supposed as n, distance traveled in 10 minutes. So in 1 minute it has traveled 110,000. So in 10 minutes we have to multiply it by 10. Okay, so it will be, there will be one more zero. Okay, and circumference is what? 80 pi. Okay, are you getting this? This is the speed, okay, for per minute. See, in 1 minute, distance traveled is what? 110,000. Okay, 110,000. So for 10 minutes, distance will be what? It is in centimeter. For 10 minutes, distance will be what? There will be one more zero. Okay, so this is the distance traveled in 10 minutes. So that I have put the value here. This zero and zero will be cancelled out. So it will be, and here it is 8 pi. So 8 into 22 and upon 7. Okay, so in the next step, 7 will go there. Okay, so it will be 77 and 40 upon 8. just divide it by 8. So what you will get? 8, when you will divide it, you will get what? 22 is also there. Okay, so if we divide it by 2, so 2 it will cancel it in 11 times, and this will be, or cancel it by 11 times, so it will be 11 to the 22, and it will be 11 7 the 77 7 4 0 okay upon 8 to the 16. Okay, now just cancel it again, just divide it by 16, so it will be 16 4 16 4 64 60 16 3 48 12 6 7 16 7 112 80 and 16 5 80. Means this is the calculation, you can do it by yourself. Okay, from here only calculation is there. When you will calculate it, what you will get? 4375. So the number of revolution each wheel make to travel the for 10 minutes by the speed of 66 km, the number of revolution each wheel make will be 4375. Okay students, the concept we have used here, the main thing is formula that we have discussed in the last part of the video. And here diameter was given, we have found radius, and from that we have found the circumference. Speed was given in 66 km per hour, we have changed it in centimeter per minute. Okay, if we have found the speed in for 1 minute, it means that in 1 minute it will have it traveled 110,000 centimeter, and then for 10 minutes we have to multiply it by 10. Okay, and that value we have put here. Okay, so basically the answer is 4375. Now you can pause the video and note it down. Now let us discuss the last question. Last question of this exercise is what? Take the correct answer in the following and justify your choice. If the perimeter and the area of the circle are numerically equal, then the radius of the circle is. Okay, so what is given here? It is given that if the perimeter of the circle, perimeter means circumference, okay, this is 2 pi r, and the area of the circle, it is pi r square. So it is given that they are numerically equal, means the value of these two according to question, okay, perimeter is equal to area of the circle. So it means 2 pi r is equal to pi r square. Okay, so pi and pi will be cancelled here. So here it is r square is equal to 2r, means r square is equal to 2r. Okay, or let us write it as it is here, 2r is equal to r square. So students, if we divide it by r, okay, means if we shift this r this side, so it will be r square by r, r and r will be cancelled out, r is equal to what? 2 centimeter. R is equal to what? 2 centimeter. Okay, so the first option is correct, r is equal to 2 centimeter. Okay, the first option is correct. So students, you can note it down, it is 2 centimeter. Just pause the video, note it down. So like this students, we have completed the exercise 12.2. In our next part, we will see exercise 10.3. Okay, and introduction of exercise 10.3. So whatever we are teaching you here, just do the practice of that. Okay, because now we are having very less time and we have to cover so many things. Okay, so just practice each and everything and prepare for board exam. Okay, time is very less students, so just utilize your time as much as you can. Okay, so thank you everyone. We'll see the exercise 12.3 in the next part. Thank you students.